Oh, let's face it, I'm just a big old fat failure.
You mean just because you had a little fight with Ginger? That happens every week. She'll make up with you. She always has before.
Yeah, but I have a feeling this time it's different.
Well, maybe she kind of takes you for granted. Why don't you go out and get yourself a date with somebody else?
Well, who, for instance?
Don't ask me. I've been out of circulation for about 30 years. There are a lot of attractive girls around the campus, aren't there?
Well, yeah, but most of them go steady with somebody. Besides, I've been going with Ginger for so long, I've kind of lost my confidence.
I think Dad's right, though. It sure would shake her up if she saw you out with another girl.
Yeah, how about Sally Parker? She's a terrific-looking girl.
Yeah, she sure is. How'd you know about her, Pop?
Well, she's the homecoming queen, the queen of the prom, isn't she?
Yeah, how'd you know that?
Well, never mind about that. How'd you know about her?
Harry, how many times have I told you not to sneak up on me when I'm talking about other girls?
Never mind. How'd you find out about her?
Her picture's in the paper here, the campus news.
Oh, hey, she is attractive. Homecoming queen, Sally Parker.
She's very friendly, too.
How friendly?
Very friendly.
How do you know?
Well, she sits next to me in psychology.
Psychology, huh? How come you haven't mentioned her before this?
Are you kidding? After all, I learned something in the course.
Oh, you're all putting me on anyway. I'd never stand a chance of getting a date with her.
Well, you never know until you try.
Well, that's right. Mrs. Nelson didn't think she'd stand a chance with me, but she just called me up one night and proposed, and we've been happily married ever since.
Until tonight.